Pop Warner Super Bowl Rap Show is presented by Genie. Gorgeous night at ESPN Wide World of Sports, and if you are a football fan, this is the place to be. The 60th Pop Warner Super Bowl, and day two is complete. Welcome to the Pop Warner Super Bowl Rap Show presented by Genie. I'm Tom James. Been a marathon day of action, and the quarterfinals in Division I is in the books. Let's start with all the highlights from the Pee Wee Division. These are the final group of games that we have been watching, and we'll start championship field, the Gilroy Browns against the Patriots, and Caleb Miller dives into the end zone for the touchdown. The team from Illinois on top early. They go for the onside kick and recover it. They are getting all the momentum and all the breaks early. Dominic Muscarnero takes the pass, and he is into the end zone. The kick was good. 16-0 Patriots. Just a few minutes into the game, they recover another fumble. It is Spencer Gorgula. And then it was Muscarnero who would take it from there, flipping in for the touchdown, 22-0. The Patriots, they let it 28-zip in the third. Gilroy trying to get on the board, and they swing it to Isaac Alvarez Saldivar. Great move to get free on the sidelines. He goes in for the touchdown, but not nearly enough. The Patriots roll. 36-6 was the final. And here are your final stats. Pretty lopsided, especially the ground game, dominated by the Patriots, 258-45. And of course, they led as well in the first down category. So the Patriots are into the semifinals. North Philly against Sweetwater. Winner of this will play the Patriots. First quarter, Charles Thompson catching the big pass all the way down near the goal line, and Micah Simmons will do the rest. As he takes it in for the touchdown, and Sweetwater took a 6-0 lead. Still in the first half, late second quarter, North Philly trying to come back, and Rashawn Wright calls his own number. The quarterback goes in for the touchdown to tie the game at 6 apiece. Still 6-all, third quarter, and a fumble, ball on the ground. Sweetwater recovers, and they look for the go-ahead score to the end zone, caught for the touchdown, and that would be the difference as Sweetwater from Miami goes on to win 13-6. That game actually not complete yet, late third quarter. We're still keeping an eye on it. Whitefield highlights, Deer Valley, the Eagles, Blake Ware with the blocked punt, takes it in for the touchdown. The Arizona crew off to an early start. Raheem Bagley then marching his way in for the touchdown. 24-0 at that point. Onto the third quarter, a 30-0 lead. Brian Dominguez Perez takes the touchdown in. Extra point was no good, no matter. 42-0, the final. Deer Valley moves on. And finally, from the blue field, Loveland, the Titans against the North Raleigh Bulldogs. Silas DeMary Jr. runs it in for a touchdown. Bulldogs on top, 8-0. Into the second quarter we go. It's DeMary Jr. again hauling this pass in for the score, 14-zip. Still in the second, pass, kind of a lame duck, and Noah Rogers is just waiting on it. Takes it into the corner for the score, 21-0. At that point, that game, late third quarter, North Raleigh pulling away up 27-zip. Let's take it to the brackets and see how it's playing out. Of course, the Patriots have advanced on. They are awaiting the Sweetwater North Philadelphia winner. That game will be the semifinal on Wednesday. And Deer Valley into the semis. Appears as though they will face North Raleigh in that semifinal game on Wednesday. And we've got junior varsity highlights up next on the Pop Warner Rap Show as we take a beautiful look at Disney Springs.
Disney soccer tournaments sponsored by AS Roma provide athletes of all ages the opportunity to compete against athletes from across the U.S. and around the world. From three-on-three youth tournaments to elite showcase events with hundreds of college recruiters present, the ESPN Wide World of Sports soccer program offers something for everyone. To find out how you can play here, visit DisneySoccer.com.
A gorgeous look at fireworks over Epcot. As we are back, ESPN Wide World of Sports, the 60th Pop Warner Super Bowl. Welcome back to the Pop Warner Rap Show, presented by Genie. And big plays just happening all over the complex this evening. Earlier this afternoon, Richmond looked so good in their game. Welcome back to the Rap Show. It is presented by Genie. I'm Tom James. Now it is time for the junior varsity games. Four games, incredible action from the junior varsity division. Let's take you to the championship field. Richmond against the Aurora Gators. And Aurora getting started early. Second quarter, they trailed Richmond 8-0. Scoring the touchdown, Michael Ignacio Jr. And we are tied at 8. Richmond back on top, 14-8. Jason Marshall into the end zone to extend the lead to 2 touchdowns, 22-8 at that point. And then the tip, the interception. Michael Jackson is in there for the touchdown, 30-8 the score at that point. Then in the third quarter, they turn to the defense. James Johnson III sacked by Thomas Kaiser. He would spend a lot of time on his back in the second half. Thomas Rittenhouse sacked. Hendrick Parrish, Jaden Jackson, a big loss right there. And the final was 30-8. Richmond Perrine moves on with a victory over Aurora. To the red field, New Haven against Arizona. Second quarter, 14-0 already. Jacobs makes it a 21-0 game. And then here's the punt. Logan Hall takes it off the bounce. Starts to his left. Heads back to his right. Looking to outrun everybody. Cuts it back inside. Down inside the 5-yard line. And that would set up the play-action pass. Matthew Fike on the business end. And the Arizona Bruisers go on to an easy 42-0 victory. On the white field, the North Philadelphia Aztecs against Oak Cliff. First quarter, North Philly on top 6-0. Roderick Daniels, though, bouncing off a defender, cutting it back inside for the Redskins and going in for the touchdown. Later in the first quarter, North Philly up 13-8. Khalif Barrett takes it in for the score. It would be 20-8 Aztecs at that time. On to the third quarter, Reginald McNeil off and running, busting through would-be tacklers, little tightrope action on the sidelines, knocked out of bounds, but no worry. Khalif Barrett finds the end zone 2 plays later for the score. 41-22 was the final. North Philly is moving on. And on the blue field, Churchland, the Tigers against the East Bay Wolves. Third quarter, still scoreless. Somebody wake up the scoreboard operator. We have action. Xavier Jones catches the long pass just before the end of the third for the score. 6-0 Tigers. And then on to the fourth, they add to it. Carnell McElroy Jr. is in to ice the game. 13-0 was the final. And your brackets, here's how it looks in junior varsity. Richmond Perrine advances. They will take on the Arizona Bruisers 10:30 in the morning on Wednesday. And the other semi, North Philly, will take on the Churchland Tigers. So we have seen 8 of 16 games so far. The varsity division is coming up next on the Pop Warner Rap Show, presented by Genie.
Disney Soccer Showcase is the ultimate place for top clubs and players to be seen by hundreds of top college coaches looking for great soccer talent. Rated the number one youth soccer tournament in the U.S. in a Soccer America survey, Disney Soccer Showcase gives athletes a chance to shine on one of the biggest and best stages set for youth soccer in the country, here at ESPN Wide World of Sports Complex. For more information, visit DisneySoccerShowcase.com.
Day two is complete at the Pop Warner Super Bowl at ESPN Wide World of Sports. Lots of big plays, offense, defense, and special teams here today at the Pop Warner Super Bowl. We welcome you back inside our Genie Studios on the Pop Warner Rap Show presented by Genie. I'm Tom James. We've seen highlights from eight games. We have eight more to go, and we'll take you to the highlights from the varsity division. The championship field, the Palmetto Raiders and the Harvey Colts. A couple of dominant teams here. Harvey, defense stepping up. Terrion Roundy strips the ball. The scoop and score 7-0. The team from Illinois in front. But Keyshawn Washington, speaking of defense, the pick six. They won't catch him. He's in there for the touchdown. Palmetto went in front 8-7 in the second quarter. Late second quarter, final minute, in fact. Marquise Irving taking the short pass for the Colts, busting through tacklers. Very hard to bring him down. And that would set up this touchdown run. Marquise Irving again. It was 14-7 at that point, Harvey. But defense was going to do the job for Palmetto. Keyshawn Washington, this guy has a nose for the football. Another pick six, his second of the game, made it 15-14 Palmetto. And just in case you were wondering, that wouldn't be all. Benny Burns got into the act as well for the Raiders. All 21 of Palmetto's points came from pick sixes. And pick six party as the Raiders are headed to the semifinals. 21-14 was the final. The Redfield Northwest Raiders against the Pompano Chiefs. It's a 6-0 game late first quarter. Carl Jones with the big gainer down inside the 25. Still the same drive. Shaquille Robinson with the reception. He does the rest. Works his way into the end zone for the score, 14-0. And in the third quarter, Northwest, Moore Robinson. This guy loves to run left, getting down inside the 30-yard line. A few plays later, Jasim Smith waiting on it and going up and getting it. The touchdown reception, Northwest rolls over Pompano 34-0. From the Whitefield, Garden Grove, the Bulldogs against Dorchester. Jawan Ryan with the football, dodging guys, running over people, down to about the 20 later in the first quarter. It's Ryan again. Might as well give him the glory. He scores the touchdown, and they're up 6-0. Garden Grove coming back. Oscar Brown is in there for the score. We move on to the second quarter. Garden Grove on top 8-6. Jonathan Barnes, though, down the sidelines, reaches the corner first. Extra point was no good. It's a 12-8 Dorchester lead. In the third quarter, Jawan Ryan pads the lead, and Dorchester goes on to win it 18-8. And they are in the semifinals. And finally, from the Bluefield, a couple of teams from out west, Santa Clara and Wailoa, the Razorbacks. Aaron Asing up the middle, outrunning everybody for the touchdown. It was 6-0 Lions at that point. In the second quarter, Santa Clara wants more. So why not give it to Asing again? He's back at it, making it look easy. The long run for the touchdown. 18-0 Santa Clara late in the second quarter. And who else? Aaron Asing. This guy was on a mission. He's got to be our player of the day. 40-6 was the final. Santa Clara is in to the final four. And here are the brackets in Varsity, Palmetto, and Northwest, 3:15 on Wednesday, and Dorchester against Santa Clara, an East-West battle for a shot at the championship round. We've got Junior Pee Wee highlights coming up next. Stay with us on the Pop Warner Rap Show.
The ESPN Wide World of Sports Complex is the ideal place for amateur softball. Hosting annual events like Disney Softball Spring Training on top of working with organizations like USSSA and Diamond 9 Events to develop competitive events for players of all ages and skill levels. For more information, visit ESPNWWOS.com.
A long day at ESPN Wide World of Sports boiled down to a few seconds. Watching the entire day on Championship Field right there in time lapse as we welcome you back to the Pop Warner Rap Show presented by Genie. I am Tom James. We've been through three divisions. So far, we've got one left to go, and it's the Junior Pee Wee. So let's take you to the highlights and show you all the action. And we'll start with the West New York Bills against the Overtown Tornadoes. Second quarter, no score. Rakeem Edwards is going to change that as he's in for the touchdown. 7-0. And then they give it to Lamar Colston. He's off to the races. In there for the score, 13-0. The Bills on top. On to the second quarter, and it's more of the same. Colston doing his thing, outrunning the defenders in there for the touchdown. And then on the pass play, more points. North Philly, a dominant showing against West Bay. The Rams, they win it 28-0. On the red field, Hartford and Far West. And the Arizona team, Braylon Gardner with the INT. And he is pushed out inside the 10-yard line. But no worry, Vance Benton Jr. is going to get him on the board for the touchdown. The route was on already. Third quarter, it's a 26-6 game. Hartford, Ellis Robinson the fourth, trying to get him back in the game as he takes off for the touchdown. It was 26-12, but too much Far West as they go on to win. 39-12 was the final as they advance to the semifinals. From the Whitefield, Virginia Beach and Oak Crest, Sincere Hawkins turning it inside for the touchdown. 18-0 Virginia Beach, just like that. Late second quarter, Joseph Graham Jr. finds the end zone. The extra point was good, 25-0 at that point, and it wouldn't stop there. Oak Cliff just dominated in this game by Virginia Beach. It's Hawkins again for the touchdown. A shutout, Virginia Beach over the team from Dallas, 37-0. They are in the semifinals. And finally, Overtown and West New York. The touchdown pass, Rakeem Edwards. It's 7-0. It was 16-0, Patriots. And the Patriots went on to win. So let's take a look at the Junior Pee Wees. The Final Four, the semifinals are set for Wednesday. And these are the early games on Wednesday. Rise and shine for North Philly against Far West and Virginia Beach against West New York. Gonna be fun. And let's take you to the blue field highlight. West New York and Overtown. Here we go. Rakeem Edwards stretches out for it, hauls it in for the touchdown, and it was 7-0. Still, same score. In the third quarter, Lamar Colston breaking through tackles, finding a seam, and he is headed for the end zone. The extra point was no good, but West New York, the Bills advance 13-7 over Overtown. And coming up, we've got your top plays of the day. We've been waiting for it. Presented by Genie as the Pop Warner Rap Show rolls on.
Disney Soccer Showcase is the ultimate place for top clubs and players to be seen by hundreds of top college coaches looking for great soccer talent. Rated the number one youth soccer tournament in the U.S. in a Soccer America survey, Disney Soccer Showcase gives athletes a chance to shine on one of the biggest and best stages set for youth soccer in the country, here at ESPN Wide World of Sports Complex. For more information, visit DisneySoccerShowcase.com.
All right, welcome back to the Pop Warner Rap Show, presented by Genie. We have seen the highlights from all 16 games today in Division I and some incredible games out there. So in 16 games over 9 hours, you know there were going to be some incredible plays. Let's take you to our top five, and we'll start with number five from junior varsity North Philly. It's Reginald McNeil. The kickoff. He stumbles for a moment. The cameraman catches up for him, and Reginald will find the end zone before they drag him down 67 yards for the score. Pee-wee, Deer Valley, the big block punt, and Blake Ware takes it in for the score. And Deer Valley was on its way to a big win. Number three, junior Pee-wee, the North Philadelphia Aztecs. 31 yards goes Saheem Williams-Rockymore. Perfect team blocking on that play. Number two from the junior Pee-wees, Virginia Beach. Gideon Moreno gets the ball out quickly. Mario Hill Jr. dragging the defenders into the end zone for the touchdown. But number one from the Pee-wees, what else? The spin by Caleb Miller and then the dive into the end zone. The Patriots would not be denied. So here's what we have for you. Division II, the semifinals coming up on Championship Field on Tuesday. We'll kick it off bright and early, 8:30 in the junior Pee-wees, Point Loma and Titletown. Then the Pee-wee division, 10:30, Northwest against Redwood City. That is followed at 1:15 by the junior varsity, Riviera Beach against Oak Cliff. And we'll wrap it up with the Unlimiteds at 3:15. Gilbert Chandler from Arizona against the Brick City Lions from New Jersey. Well, of course, on a somber note, we have all been affected by someone in our lives who have had cancer or been affected by cancer. It's Jimmy V. Week, our old friend here at ESPN. Jimmy V. Week for cancer research. Of course, 1 in 2 men, 1 in 3 women will develop cancer in their lifetime. Second most common cause of death in the United States. But if you would like to help, all you have to do is log on to jimmyv.org or just call 1-800-4-JIMMY-V to donate. Such an incredible cause. What an incredible weekend it has been at ESPN Wide World of Sports. That's going to do it for the Pop Warner Rap Show presented by Genie. I'm Tom James. Have a great night, everybody.